Timeless concepts from physics helpline. In this video tutorial, we will discuss a multiple choice question on the magnetic field produced by an infinitely long straight conductor carrying a current. The question is as follows. Read the question carefully. The situation is shown in the figure. The two dots shown here at A and B are two infinitely long straight wires A and B placed perpendicular to the plane of the figure. The distance between the wires AB is equal to 0.1 meters. Both the wires A and B carry equal currents of 10 ampere in the same direction, which is out of the plane of the figure. Now, P is a given point at which we will determine the magnetic field due to the two wires. It is given that PA is equal to PB, PA is equal to PB, which is equal to 0.1 meters, which makes triangle PAB an equilateral triangle. We are required to find the net magnetic field at point P due to the two current carrying wires. Now, for the answer, the magnetic field produced by an infinitely long straight conductor carrying current I at a perpendicular distance r from it is given by B is equal to mu 0 I by 2 pi r. Conveniently, we will write this as B is equal to mu 0 by 4 pi into 2 I by r, because we happen to know the value of mu 0 by 4 pi. Now, current in the two wires A and B are equal. Distance of the point P from both the wires A and B are also equal. Therefore, the magnitudes of the magnetic field produced by both the wires at P are also equal. Therefore, we write BA, magnitude of BA is equal to magnitude of BB, which is equal to mu 0 by 4 pi into 2 I by r. Putting the value mu 0 by 4 pi is equal to 10 to the power minus 7, 2 into I is equal to 10 divided by r is equal to 0.1. Simplifying, we get BA is equal to BB, which is equal to 2 into 10 to the power minus 5 Tesla. We denote, because both the magnitudes are equal, we denote them as B. Therefore, we have written B is equal to 2 into 10 to the power minus 5 Tesla. Now, in the triangle PAB, we observe that AB is equal to PA is equal to PB. All of them, all the sides are equal to 0.1 meters. So, they are equal. Therefore, triangle PAB is equilateral. Therefore, the angles are all each equal to 60 degrees. So, we have written angle PAB is equal to angle PBA is equal to angle APB, which is equal to 60 degrees. Now, the direction of BA is perpendicular to AP. Therefore, this angle is 90 degrees. It is denoted, or BA is acts along PM. Similarly, the magnetic field produced by B, wire B, is BB, which is perpendicular to BP, which acts along PN. Now, angle between PA and PB is equal to 60 degrees. Therefore, angle between their perpendiculars, that is PM and PN, is also equal to 60 degrees. Therefore, the angle between the two magnetic field vectors BA and BB is also equal to 60 degrees. So we have written angle MPN is equal to 60 degrees. We will use the following expression for the magnitude of the resultant of two vectors A and B, given by R is equal to root over A square plus B square plus 2 into A into B into cos theta. So the resultant magnitude of the two magnetic fields is given by BP, means the resultant magnetic field at P is denoted by BP, which is equal to root over BA square plus BB square. Because BA and BB are both denoted as B, we write for BA square, we write B square, for BB square, we write B square, and plus 2 into BA into BB, which is again equal to B into B, and cos theta, and theta in this case is 60 degrees, therefore cos 60 degrees. Now, for simplification, cos 60 is equal to 1 by 2, therefore it gets cancelled with 2 to give us B square plus B square plus B square, that is your root over 3B square, which is equal to root 3 into B. Now, B is equal to 2 into 10 to the power minus 5 Tesla, therefore root 3 into 2 into 10 to the power minus 5 Tesla, that is your BP, which on simplification gives BP is equal to 2 root 3 into 10 to the power minus 5 Tesla, which is the answer to the question. Therefore, the correct option is B. This completes the answer to the question. Thanks for watching. If the video is helpful, then please like, share and subscribe.